Super Smash Bros. Ultimate is right around the corner. I feel like I've been struggling to find things to talk about until the game comes out, at which point I can start making some new character-focused videos, which I know a lot of you have been asking about. However, there's one thing that's been on my mind, DLC. During the last Smash Bros. Direct, it was confirmed that we'll be getting 5 new characters as DLC. And these won't be Echoes either, they'll be 5 brand spanking new characters, as well as 5 new stages. Sounds great, but what about content other than characters or stages? How about Mii costumes? New modes? For this video, I'm just going to talk about my hopes for the DLC. First off, I'll get into the DLC characters. Thanks to a tweet that Sakurai made recently, we know that the DLC fighters were selected by Nintendo. Also, the full DLC lineup has been decided already, which is interesting to say the least. And maybe a teensy bit worrisome? Don't get me wrong, I trust Nintendo, but honestly, I don't think we'll be getting a bunch of fan favorite picks like Banjo or Geno. In fact, I'll be surprised if we get either of those. My hope would be we at least get 1 or 2 characters that fans have been demanding for a long time. Someone like Sora seems more likely than ever. Kingdom Hearts 3 is coming up very soon, so it's a perfect chance for cross-promotion. Both Smash Bros. And Kingdom Hearts would benefit from something like that. If we get characters along those lines, I think most fans would be pretty happy. Also, I don't think Nintendo is simply going to shove in characters no one wants. I mean, that wouldn't be successful, it wouldn't sell, so it wouldn't even make sense. But I don't think Nintendo thought only of Smash fans when deciding characters. They would likely want to bring fans of other series into the mix as well. So someone like Steve from Minecraft doesn't sound too far-fetched. It's an insanely successful game that continues to sell well. I just hope Nintendo made good choices that can get all kinds of people excited. I don't expect every DLC character to be my cup of tea, and that's fine. If there's even just one character that can get me super hyped, I'll be happy. We also know we're getting 5 new stages, since each fighter comes with a new stage. Now, I would imagine the stage we get is probably themed to the character we're getting, so there's not much to say here. But my most wanted character is Banjo, so if we do get him, I hope his stage is Spiral Mountain. And of course, we also know that with each new character, we get a bunch of new songs. But again, there's not much to say since we don't know what characters we're getting. So now I'll go into some other categories that aren't confirmed and are just my own hopes and thoughts about what else they could do for DLC. Obviously, Mii fighters are back, and with that comes the prospect of Mii costume DLC. Smash 4 had a ton of costumes as DLC. Now, to be honest, I'm not a big fan of the Mii fighters, so getting more costumes as DLC isn't exactly something that I'm hoping for. Plus, we don't know the exact amount of costumes that are unlockable in the game, so it's possible there's no real need for them. We already have the Rex Mii costume that you can get from buying the Fighter's Pass, which, admittedly, I will be doing, but I don't really see the need for more Mii costumes right now. Part of me hopes that they don't do that and instead focus their efforts on something a bit more interesting. How about alt costumes for the other fighters? Mario already has several alt costumes, and I wish more characters would get the same treatment. I would love to see Samus get an alt that looks like her armor from Samus Returns, or better yet, her fusion suit, which is my personal favorite. Alt costumes for the normal fighters is absolutely something I would pay for. The modding scene was pretty huge for Smash 4, so maybe Nintendo saw that and knows how much people like alternate costumes. It just seems like easy money, so why not? Another possibility could be new modes, or rather, returning modes that aren't in the game. As far as we know, Home Run Contest is not in Smash Bros. Ultimate. I could see something like that coming as a free update. Tournament mode also doesn't seem to be a part of the online, so there's potential there as well. I know the online tourney mode in Smash 4 was not very good, in fact it was pretty bad, but that doesn't mean they can't improve upon that and give us something better. After seeing the way online tournaments worked in Mario Tennis Aces, I was hoping Ultimate would get something similar. My biggest hope would be the return of Break the Targets, and I'm talking like how it was back in Smash 64 and Melee, a unique stage for each fighter. Now that's just a pipe dream, as I think that's expecting a little too much, since we'll have 80 characters once the DLC comes out. I guess they could handle it the way it was in Brawl, where it was just a set of stages that any character could access, but I honestly wasn't a big fan of that. The way I see it, either do it right or don't do it at all. I was never a big fan of Stage Builder either, but if they were to improve upon it heavily, that would be a nice feature too. Then again, we have so many good stages to choose from in Ultimate, so I doubt I get much use out of it. In fact, that's probably the reason it didn't come back to begin with. It would be awesome to get a completely new mode as an update, but I don't really have any specific ideas. I do wish we could play Squad Strike online though. I guess my final hope is just that the game has a steady flow of updates. All of the fighters are planned to be released by the end of February 2020, so basically one fighter every few months or so. Having smaller updates in between that would be nice, which is where something like a home run contest or new online mode update would be good. To be clear, I don't think Ultimate is lacking in content at all. This game is massive and is going to have enough content to keep me busy for well over a year. However, one reason I continue to go back to a game like Splatoon 2 is because of all of the constant updates. I think Smash Bros. Has the potential to receive similar treatment. Regardless, come December 7th, we're all in for a treat. My hype is through the roof right now. We're less than 3 weeks away. Sakurai and the team have truly crafted something special. Anyway, that's about it from me. Let me know your thoughts and hopes for the DLC down below. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll catch you later.